Welcome back to my Road to Completion Guide for Little Nightmares 2. This is the final episode of the series. Go outside and touch the glitched remain in the sewer. We have a lot of platforming coming up, so I'm going to let you enjoy the gameplay. I'll come back in with commentary once we reach the elevator. Pull the switch in the elevator, but don't ride it all the way to the top. Instead, jump to the first platform on the right. Go into the office and grab the key from the bottom drawer. Open the gate, pull the switch, then step off the elevator. Pull the switch on the wall, then drop on top of the elevator. Pull the box, move through the vent, and touch the glitched remain standing on the mattress. Make your way across the rooftops to the small room full of cages. Inside, you'll find another glitched remain. We have more platforming to do before we reach the next TV. The only thing to worry about is a very short running sequence where the roof caves in, but as long as you maintain a steady sprint, you'll be safe. It's a scripted event past a certain point, so eventually you'll fall in a hole and share a short cutscene with Six.
Thank you.
run away from the tall man and hide under the bed in the next room. After the cutscene, touch the TV again. This area is comprised of puzzles, and the goal is to operate and teleport between TVs to continue the story. Eventually, we'll grab a TV remote, which can turn TVs on and off by pressing the circle button. I'll pop in with commentary when it's time to pick up a collectible or unlock a trophy, but until then, enjoy the gameplay. Go into the crawl space, grab the mail carrier's hat, and put it on. Go outside and enter the building through the other window. Touch the last glitched remain to unlock two trophies. No More Remains and Pale Kids. Break the statue to unlock a trophy called Unladylike. Continue working your way through the area, solving more TV puzzles. Remove the boards on the door and quickly flip the switch before the enemy catches you. Make sure to flip the switch again to avoid being electrocuted. Open the suitcase, grab the package, and deliver it to the man in the next room to unlock another trophy. turn off the TV and jump to the toilet to kill the woman. Move the shopping cart to the shelf near the window so we can get the golf hat. Push the shopping cart down the ramp and I'll show you how to turn off the power. Push the shopping cart to the other side of the shelf and make a few practice jumps to ensure you have it in the correct position. You only have one chance to make the jump from the shelf to the TV because landing in the electrified water forces you to complete this sequence again. When you're ready, turn the power on, cross the gap, and interact with the TV. Get ready for another chase sequence after teleporting through this TV. Thank you. quickly grab the weapon, bash through the door, and climb the wall in the next room to escape. Stop here to avoid being detected. Quickly move the stool, jump to the platform, and remove the boards before the tall man reaches you. Run through the train cars and flip the switch to end the chase sequence. Climb the ladder at the end of the alley. Use the left thumbstick to point electricity at the tall man until he's defeated. Hold up on the left thumbstick to continue the story. enter the glowing area to unlock another trophy. Find the doors playing the loudest music to complete the door maze. Press triangle to bait six to the right side of the room, so we'll have access to a weapon. Use the weapon to hit the music box, then run to avoid being caught by six. Under the table until six leaves the room. grab the axe and call out to Six. While she's distracted, teleport to the other side of the room and hit the music box. Use the same tactic as before, but this time we'll have to move through extra doors. The only difference this time around is we'll have to quickly grab the weapon after teleporting. Grab the axe, call for Six, and destroy the music box. Keep running to avoid being consumed. Sit in the chair to complete the game. This action unlocks the Signal Separation Trophy, plus gives us the final hat we need to complete our collection. Since two hats are related to the DLC, we only had to collect 10 to unlock the Far Ahead Trophy. Both of these trophies will pop just before the credits. There's no way to skip the credits, but you can fast forward them by tapping down on the left thumbstick. Replay Chapter 2 using Chapter Select. Throw on the fedora to unlock the final trophy and the platinum. If you enjoy my Road to Completion series, head over to Patreon and become a member for $1 or more per month. I have a ton of rewards like workbooks and visual guides that can provide even more assistance when you're trophy hunting. The only way this channel can remain active is if the community backs future projects, so make a pledge if you can. My name is Exonovant, and I'll see you in the next one. Be good.